American Water Polo.
Hi, this is Dave Manuma from American Water Polo, and we're here today with head coach Luis Nicolao from the US Naval Academy to better understand their college recruiting process. How you doing, Louis?
Good, Damon. How you doing?
I'm doing well. I appreciate you taking the time.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, no problem. So tell me a little bit about yourself and about the Naval Academy.
Well, as you know, it's kind of crazy times right now. I'm back here going into my third year after 20 years at Princeton. And honestly, trying to keep busy, trying to keep the guys engaged as best we can, you know, doing dry land workouts and Zooms once a week. But it's new territory for everybody.
Yeah, it is. I completely agree with you. So speaking about recruiting, you know, how do athletes get recruited? You know, what should they do to promote themselves?
Well, Damon, it's a great question, because right now it's just, you know, for whether you're an athlete or not an athlete, this is the time that everybody be doing college visits, you know, trying to figure out as juniors where you're going to go, and where you're going to pick, and that's not happening. And right. You got now high schools with pass-fail grades, you got no subject tests this year. It's going to be a really different year next year when it comes to admissions and recruiting processes. For kids, I would recommend, you know, email coaches, you know, send videos, do what you can to stay in touch. I know for us, we're trying to do as much as we can on social media to keep Navy in the limelight for people. And I know a lot of schools are doing that. If you see on Twitter and Instagram, a lot of college programs are out there trying to promote their programs. But really, you know, it's just a matter of trying to communicate and get yourself out there as best you can for these kids. I feel bad for them, whether they're an athlete or not. Many of these kids may have to make decisions sight unseen. Much like us, for college coaches, we may have to make decisions on kids not having seen play in over a year. And there's no JO this summer. There's no summer water polo. It's going to be a very uncharted waters this fall in terms of how recruiting goes for both the recruit and the coaches, because it's so different.
Yeah, that's very true. So how would you say, like, the high school coaches and the club coaches, how do they play a role for the athletes, you know, obviously in a traditional year, but, you know, obviously in an extraordinary year?
They're vital. You know, I actually heard a recruit talk to me yesterday about the admissions directors talk about how teacher recs are so vital this year because a lot of classes are pass-fail. Well, the same in recruiting. You know, if we're not seeing you play, who can we talk to? Your coaches. And they're going to be honest, and they're going to be vital in this process, telling you whether or not this kid can help you or not, good kid character-wise. The high school coaches, club coaches are going to be a vital piece in this, just like the high school teachers are, because you're not going to have a lot to go on. It's going to be a lot of calling people and, hey, tell me about this kid. Do you think, you know, he or she wants us? Vice versa, the college club coaches calling coaches and saying, hey, you really want to look at this kid. This kid's really interested in your school. It's going to be a vital piece of the recruiting process, because we're not going to be able to watch these kids or get to meet these kids.
Right. That's very true. So speaking about character and the input from the high school and club coaches, what do you think some of those character traits are that coaches are looking for, you know, in a PSA?
I think you're looking for a team player that just loves water polo. I'm a big believer, team chemistry in the locker room is everything. You know, in my years, over the years at Princeton, now at Navy, I've had some great teams that maybe locker room-wise didn't get along, and we didn't win. Right. And then teams that were just – together every step in stride, and maybe not the most talented, and they won, and it was so rewarding. Chemistry is everything. I think you see it at the professional level, high school level, club level. If you're not getting along in the club, in the locker room, clubhouse, you don't love each other, it's hard to compete. It's hard to do well.
Yeah, I would say that's a pretty, that's very. Yeah.
There's days that, you know, I'd hate going to practice as a coach because it was so hard. The kids were not having fun, and then there's days I couldn't wait to get to practice. You know, for me, it's all about having fun, and winning is key. If you're not winning, you're not having fun. And there's a lot of pieces into that process of having fun. And if the kids aren't getting along, you're not going to be having a good time.
Right. I would agree with that. So you have an athlete, you know, PSA, who might be looking at, you know, Naval Academy or another school. You know, they're preparing for, say, a phone conversation with the coach. What would you recommend them doing in preparation?
Everything online, all the information is online now. I think these kids, especially now with all this time, do their homework. Know the size squads and the sizes of the squads and where these kids are from and the school's location. And there's record last year. You know, you prepared just like you would for a job interview. Be able to tell that coach, hey, nice job last year, or you had a tough year, or I see you have a few players from my hometown. That's awesome. You know, make that coach think, hey, this kid's really interested in my school. Don't get on a phone call and not have a question prepared, not know, you know, what's going on with their program, who they lost graduation-wise. Today for kids, all the information is at your fingertips. It's all online. So if you have three or four schools you're interested in, you're going to talk to those coaches. Just do some homework online before that phone call happens.
Right. Yeah. And I'm sure you've had many phone conversations over the years and now some more text messages.
Oh, well, now it's all text.
Right.
You know,
right.
I talked to a parent, you know, I said, I talked to your kid today. That means we texted.
Right.
You know? These kids don't want to talk. There's no phone calls. I thought I wouldn't like it, Damon. I love it because it takes out the awkwardness. And I could have four or five conversations with four different recruits in a 20-minute span and be done. Where phone calls would take hours.
Yeah. You know?
It's great.
It's so much different now. Yeah, the communication is and just the way that they want to communicate and the way coaches now have to communicate with athletes.
So. Yeah, and I would tell all these kids, if you have, you know, if you're into water polo or football, whatever it is, follow those schools on social media. You know, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, because I always put stuff out there that keeps you informed what's going on. So if you do get a surprise phone call, you may have seen something on Twitter or Instagram that will spark a question from you or a conversation.
Right. So you talked a little bit earlier about, you know, obviously the unprecedented times we're going through right now with the COVID outbreak and the loss of some larger tournaments that traditionally would go on now are being postponed or even canceled. You know, what should it do? What should a PSA do to be seen? You talked a little bit about highlight film, game film. Could you expand a little more on that?
Yeah, I think as coaches, we all know the limitations that are going on. You know, all the pools are closed.
Right.
So if you have some high school video, great club video, send it. But I think you really got to use this time to sit down with your high school coach, club coach, tell him or her what you want to do for college, and make sure that they're reaching out to us to get you on their radar. That's probably the most important thing. We understand you're not playing, you can't be playing. This is almost a redshirt year. Your body's going to get healthier. Shoulders will get some rest. But I think right now it's just all about getting those communication lines opened up, you know, so that coaches can talk to your coaches and figure out if you're the right fit or not.
Excellent. So you've been at this for a number of years. Can you give me a couple of like common misconceptions that you've had over the years about the recruiting process?
Yeah, you know, one thing I've been surprised about is how little, you know, parents know. I think you see football and basketball and you hear about these recruiting wars. In our sport, I joke, coaches are lazy. You have to sell yourself. You got to be your own advocate. You got to be like you're applying for a job. Don't expect us to come knocking on your door unless you're 6'5", left-handed. There's not a lot of those kids out there, Ashley Johnsons of the world. You got to sell yourself and don't be afraid to be a pest. Put emails together. Unless a coach says, hey, we're not interested in you, once every 2 weeks, put an email out there. Recruiting, it's a chess match. And, you know, and you got to go out there and play the game and sell yourself and you communicate and be your own advocate and understand that don't take things personal. You know, water polo is a 20-man roster. You have four or five spots per year. Just because you may not fit in a certain school doesn't mean you're not good enough. Yeah, it just may not be that what they're looking for that year. So just go out there, open your ranges, open the schools you're looking at, have some safety schools, and I can't emphasize enough, be your own advocate and do it yourself, not mom and dad. You know, you're going to college. You're the one that needs to make this decision. Your mom and dad, I know, have your best interests in mind, but they're not going to play at college. They're not going to be in the dorms. Make sure you're the one making the phone calls, sending the emails. And if you do send a group email, make sure you cut and paste the right coach's name on it. You know, that's always a good one when we get an email and it's directed for, it says a different coach's name on it. Make sure you just proofread your email and have the right school and the right coach on it.
Yeah. That's some good advice. Well, final question. You have an athlete who's interested in the Naval Academy or another college in general. You know, what should their first step be?
Contact the coach. Get online now. Get the recruiting questionnaire done. If you're a junior, most of these, all these schools now have the admission process online, research, start the admissions process. It's all about the application, okay? Everything's about the application, teacher recs, your essays, get started on it. Because it comes fast. Before you know it, it's fall, and if you're applying early decisions in some school, that's 1 November. Before you know it, that's on you. So what I'd recommend is get online, see what the requirements are for the application, admissions process, go to the sports page, email the coach, and get that communications lines opened up.
Awesome. Excellent. Well, this has been Luis Nicolao from US Naval Academy giving us more information about the college recruiting process. I'm Damon Newman from American Water Polo. Check us out on Instagram, Facebook, AmericanWaterPolo.org. And remember, it's important to stay connected to what's important to you. Thanks a lot, Louie. I appreciate it.
Thanks, Damon, for having me. Stay safe.
All right, you too.